the road.
Katika kitabu cha Mathayo ilikuwa watu wapofu wawili ambao walikuwa simama kando ya barabara ningeni mwa barabara.
And Jesus is walking through Jericho.
Na wakati mwingine Yesu alikuwa anapita kuelekea Jericho.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now these two people, they're screaming out of their heart, out of their stomach guts, they're just screaming, "Oh Jesus, have mercy on us."
Na hao watu walikuwa nalilia, walikuwa napiga kelele wakisema kwamba Yesu utupe kibali machoni mwa.
There are two people, there are two blind people.
Na walikuwa pofu wawili.
They might have heard so many things about Jesus, what Jesus was doing all around that place.
Hao pofu walishasikia wakisikia ujumbe wa Yesu na mazuri ambayo Yesu anatenda kwa kitu.
They were blind, they could not see anything.
Lakini walikuwa wapofu wangeweza kuona.
But they were able to hear the people when they are gossiping or the people when they are walking, they're talking about Jesus.
Lakini walikuwa na kibali ya kusikia na kusikia hadithi ambayo watu walikuwa nasema wanapopita.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, in this world, one thing we have to learn very carefully, or one thing we have to understand very carefully.
Hapa duniani jambo moja ambalo ni vizuri tuweze kusoma kabisa na tuweze kutambua kabisa.
That we have to be blind.
Ya kwamba ni vyema tukue wapofu.
Why we have to be blind?
Kwa nini nataka tu hapo?
So that we don't see the worldly things which are surrounded us.
Ili tusione vitu vya dunia ambavyo vimetuzingira.
But we should be ready to listen to the voice of the Lord.
Lakini tukuwe tayari kusikia sauti ya Mungu.
We should be ready to listen to the voices of the God's sense of God's people.
Ni vyema sana tusikie habari ya watume ambao wametumwa.
And when the Holy Spirit is there in midst of us.
Na wakati Roho Mtakatifu atashuka katikati
yetu. To cry unto the Holy Spirit.
Glory to God.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So many times what happens is like we do come to the church. We go in the presence of the Lord. But we don't call the Lord. We just come that Lord, I need something from you. We are just after the worldly things. Or we want to say that Lord, today I need to listen to you.
Lakini ni vyema ukaseme Mungu nataka nisikie ujumbe wako.
Let your word talk to my heart.
Glory to God.
Let me carry your presence with me.
Wacha utukufu wako wetu.
When I go back home.
Ili alafu nirudi nyumba.
When I go back home.
Nikirudi kule nyumba.
I still go and whenever I meet someone on the road I say, "Oh brother, praise the Lord. Why did you come to church today?"
Nikirudi nyumbani niko huru kueleza mtu mwingine tena
kwa nini kuja kanisa. Today.
Glory.
Why? Because that anointing you're carrying along with you. These two blind people. They don't see anything. But they understood that Jesus is walking down there. Just think. When you start praying. When you start to ask the Holy Spirit. People will ask you, just be quiet. When you go in fasting prayer, people will say, "Oh, just be quiet." When Jesus is walking, the multitude came and asked those people to just be quiet. Many people they think like when they're doing the ministry, they're with the Lord. We know about the lady who was having blood flow for 12 years. There are hundreds and thousands of people touching Jesus Christ. But only when one woman touches Jesus.
Uyo mama moja tu ndiye aliweza kushika
kitu. I felt someone has touched me.
Glory to God.
Praise
the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
No matter there are 100 people in the church.
Haijalishi watu wengi wako kanisa yako.
No matter there are 1,000 people in the church.
Haijalishi watu 1,000 wako kanisa lako.
No matter there are only my wife and me in the church.
Haijalishi tuko wawili katika kanisa lako.
I have the same anointing.
Glory to Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes I go outside and I start praying and I feel the presence of the Lord walking with me. Why is that? Because I close my eyes. I don't think what the people are saying about me. What people talk about me. What people say good or bad about me. I don't worry about it. My business here in this world.
Jambo
kini changu cha hapa duniani
is to pray for the lost souls.
Ni kutafuta kuombea
mioyo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Matthew 6:33.
Matayo 6:33.
Okay, we listen to that verse so many times in our lives.
Tumesikia hiyo ujumbe wakati nyingi sana katika maisha yetu.
Seek ye first the kingdom of the Lord.
Na kwamba safuteni ufalme wa Mungu.
What is the kingdom of the Lord?
Ufalme wa Mungu ni kitu gani?
Pray for your neighbor.
Na kwamba ombea jirani wako.
Pray for the people to whom you go every day to take milk, to vegetables, to your things in the shop.
Ombea watu wote ambao unaenda kuchukua shughuli zako kila wakati kila kitu
mnayonunua. Every day you go and meet those people.
Wakati wote unaenda kukutana na watu hawa.
One day those people they die.
Wakati ngine watu walikufa.
And they go to hell.
Wataenda kwa moto.
At the time of judgment.
Na siku ya hukumu.
God is going to ask you.
Na wewe ndio utauliza.
Every day you met that person.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
You saw that person.
My God.
Na wewe mwenye bakipiki.
For your weddings and for your functions you call that person.
Kila wakati kwenye sherehe zote ulikuwa unakutana na huyo jamaa.
But did you invite him for your church?
Lakini au
oh yes.
You pray for that also.
Au kwa unaombea mioyo.
God is going to ask you that.
Utaulizwa swali kaka.
Today if I'm here in Africa.
Leo kama niko hapa katika nchi.
I'm just not over here just to come It is God who has called me to be a missionary here in East Africa.
Yes.
Every day we are going outside and meeting different churches, different pastors. We are meeting so many people on the road. Are we lifting up your hands and walking and saying, God, I need these souls? Whenever I'm traveling. Once I finish talking to my wife over the phone. I say, Lord, I want these souls.
Oh,
yes.
To
reach up to these people.
Glory.
How can I go to these people? If I'm here in this church, if I'm preaching you the word of the Lord, if I'm praying along with you, I'm giving you the word of the Lord. The blessings of the Lord are falling on you. It's upon you now how many people you're going to bring in the church.
Reality. Reality.
That is what is the seeking for the kingdom of the Lord. Go back to those blind people.
Ukirudi kwenye wale wapo.
When Jesus came to them.
Na Yesu aliwarudia.
And Jesus asked them.
Na Yesu akauliza.
What do you want?
Kitu gani unahitaji?
If God today comes down here.
Kama Yesu anashuka hapa leo.
If he asks you what you want.
Na amekuuliza chenye unahitaji.
I have a very big list.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is the only thing I need?
Lakini kitu gani unahitaji?
That God, if you have called me as a pastor. God, if you call me as an evangelist, give me the strength, give me the power so I can bring the souls unto you.
Yes, reality, reality, reality.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. My Lord says that I will provide you your daily bread. I don't have to fill up my house and say I have a ration for almost a year. Every day morning when I get up, I say, Lord, please provide me a daily bread.
Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Glory!
And then I say to the Lord, give me at least one soul I can pray for. And I'm praying for many souls.
Oh my God.
The
anointing which is flowing in me. The anointing which is flowing in your pastor. That comes upon you once you come in his presence.
Glory to Jesus.
Because we are not ordinary people. We are not like the worldly people. We are the
Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Do you not know that you are the temple of the Lord? Everyone is having the Holy Spirit.
But
the
pastor is helping you.
Glory!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
When those two blind people, when God says, "What she
want?"
He
said,
"We want to see."
We want to see.
And once this started seeing.
Na walianza kuona.
What they did?
Kitu gani walifanya?
They followed Jesus.
Walifuata Yesu.
And they become witnesses to the other
people. Na waka wakuwa washuhudaji katika ile mataifa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every person in the Bible who was healed, who got testimony in their life.
Kila mtu kwenye andiko walikuwa na ushuhuda katika maisha yao.
They became a minister, so they become a witness.
Oh yeah.
Na walikuwa washuhuda na watumishi wa Mungu wenye walikuwa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning time.
Yeah, asubuhi wale.
The message which came to you.
Oh, ujumbe ambao imekukujia.
That was from the Holy Spirit.
Imeondoka kwa Mungu.
In my spirit I can sense the Holy Spirit is still over you.
Ah, na kwangu mnaweza sema kwa Roho Mtakatifu bado iko.
It was a very very powerful message from the pastor who will preach today.
Oh, hiyo yote ambayo imetoka kwa mchungaji ambaye amehubiri leo.
If you open our hearts.
Ukifungua roho yako.
What all is your need?
Oh, hallelujah.
What all is your sickness?
My God.
God is healing you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Receive it in the power.
Glory, thank face and tap it up and this capacity
ability. Any problem you're having right now, say, give your hand on the chest and say, God, I want healing.
Tatizo zote ambazo kuna kwa mchungaji.
Naidi sakwiti precious and divine David
sakatwa prata. Lord, I want to grow my ministry.
Kama uzito ingine, ambia kwa Mungu, njoo kwa Mungu nasema nataka ubariki kwa.
So just keep on saying, Lord, please use me.
Hebu endelea ukisema kwa
Mungu. Use me, Jesus.
Use me for the extension of your kingdom.
Use me, Lord, for the extension of your kingdom. For the furtherance of your kingdom. Hallelujah.
Oh, wacha tusimame.
Hallelujah.
Ah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you want the blessings of the Lord this afternoon.
Kama unataka baraka zake Mungu juu ya leo.
This afternoon, if you want to receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Masante safasi na peliti. Hallelujah.
Open up your hearts. Hallelujah.
I worship you, Jesus, Son of God. You're worthy, my God. You're worthy, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, my Redeemer. Use me, Father, as your vessel to extend your kingdom, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, take over, take charge, take full control in the name of
the Lord. Spoke to us about blindness. It's a time that we as Christians, if you want to succeed and overcome the worldly things, the temptation, trials, and all the last spirits, we must be blind.
Yes, Jesus.
Don't move with the outer eye.
Yes, Jesus.
But try by all means for the Lord to give you the inner eye.
Oh, yes.
The inner eye will see the things of heaven.
Yes.
But the outer eye will see the beauty of women. And beautiful man, and on how you can get money,
oh yes,
in a way that it cannot please God.
Amen.
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 So for us to succeed in this journey, please let us change our mind and start thinking positively. Amen. If we know that in every our activity, daily activities, yes, we are going to please God.
Amen.
Think that you are working to somebody else, someone who is a greater man. Someone who is
so, oh, yes.
So practice well in his sight for him to come and bless you, for him to come and protect you, for him to come and fight for you. Practice well. Don't mix up with evil things and worldly things. Be blind, please. Be blind, and the glory of the Lord will come upon you. Be blind, and you will maintain that righteousness. Be blind.
Oh, yes.
Receive power from above. Be blind. And the Lord will fight for you. Be blind and receive the secret things that those have been hiding in the dark place. Amen.
Amen.
God will come and provide everything to you. God will fight for your peace in your marriage, because now you are blind to the things of the world. If you are going to have inner eye, you will not see peace.
Amen.
Peace, you are the peace that you are using, that beautiful hair, is from the kingdom of the darkness. And if you are going to maintain blindness, that one, you are going to be blind to the world. You will not see those things. You will not see one guy. You will not see cutex. You will not see all the beautiful things. You will not see the pencil. You will not see Peralpusa. You will not see Yori Yori.
Oh,
you will
yes.
not see all those things.
Glory to God.
We say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be blind and see only Jesus.
Come on.
Please, you are God.
Yes.
In everything you do. In your daily basis, daily life. Please, the Messiah. Amen.
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 And we are going to overcome the world.
Yes.
And we see the Lord in everything you do. May God bless you abundantly. May God bless your houses. May God bless your businesses.
Oh,
may
yes.
God bless your visions.
Amen.
May God bless the education of your children.
Amen.
May God provide everything in your life. May God bless your jobs. When people are going to cry because employment is not going to be there, you are not going to cry with them. Because God will come for your rescue.
Amen.
Pray the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Attain righteousness and see the power of the Lord upon your life. Stand with the pastor. Work for the church.
Oh yes.
Or the little thing that you are going to get, share with your son, with your pastor. There is no day God will come walk into your place.
Yes.
And say that today I'm Jehovah God, I've come to visit you. For you to be connected with God, do something to your pastor.
Yes.
To touch his spirit. If you see your pastor is crying after receiving your gift, know that God, you are touching the spirit of God.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Amen. Reality, 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 reality.
Any gift that you, if you see you give pastor something, you offer him something, and he's just going like that when he's laughing. Yes. Know that is call box. That is
the call box. Call box.
But any gift that you touch the spirit of a pastor, and you see a pastor is crying, a pastor is coming back and pray for you. That is the gift that touches the spirit of the Lord.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Amen.
Learn to touch the spirit of God always.
Through the pastor.
And you will be a servant of God.
Glory.
That God will not doubt. It's not just a matter of crying here, falling down day and night, and nothing good you can do that can touch the spirit of the servant.
Oh, yes.
That is the secret.
Oh my God.
That woman came to the kingdom because of giving. Through connected with David in the wilderness, he offered some beautiful things that touched the spirit of David. Amen. And after that is how God started working for her. After the death of the husband, now God took her to David. And she was remained in the king's life because of the gift he offered to David. Amen.
Amen.
Baada ya kupeana mali zake kwa Daudi na bwana yake akakufa sababu bwana alikuwa mjinga, kuna kitu kizuri lakini hajui kutumia. Mama mwenye anafanya kazi na nguvu zake zote na amejua kuvaa vizuri na anakula vizuri na mwili yake iko vizuri, hajui kutumia hiyo mke ambaye ako naye. Mungu amechukua kwa sababu amejua kutumia mtumishi wa Mungu. Mungu akamchukua huyo mke akapatia Daudi akapeana kabisa. Huyo mke mwenye alisimama na Daudi wakati anakaribishwa kwenye kiti. Unaweza kaa hapa wewe mama lakini ujui Bwana ambaye uko naye. Ujui Bwana ambaye uko naye.
Unamuona
tu kama mtu kawaida.
Oh yes.
Mtumishi wa Mungu ambaye amepakwa.
Yes.
Hiyo imefanya wake wengi wamekufa watumishi wa Mungu kwa sababu hawajijui. You don't know yourself. You must know the kind of person you are.
Glory to God.
Honor that man because he's anointed man. If you get opportunity to be with that guy beside you the whole night, when other women are spending a day, spending the whole night outside waiting for that your beautiful husband, be very careful.
Glory to Jesus.
Many women, almost thousands of them, are awaiting your husband in Condele. Without putting any good clothes. And you have received a great opportunity to have that husband that are believing in you, love you, work it for your life, and you don't want to honor him.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Don't bring that stupidity here in salvation. Go back and start working to your husband as a king. If you want to remain as a queen, work to your husband as a king.
As a king.
Take that husband as a king. Everything you do to that husband, do as a king. Take water.
Because all men are sick, man. All men are sick.
Are sick.
If you want to know how you can work for your husband and love you, take that person as a sick person.
Mm.
A sick person, you will do everything for him.
Unamudumia.
Utamudumia. Ama vipi.
Amen.
Kama unataka Bwana kupende, chukua Bwana yako kama mgonjwa. Mgonjwa utakuja asubuhi mahali analala, utamuguza kichwa yake. Leo umeamuka.
Ichio nade.
Ichio nadimbie.
Hallelujah.
Bwana sifiwe sana.
Hallelujah.
Na nakurudisha kwamba nimeamuka vizuri. Sasa unasikia unaweza kula nini, ni kuwete, pele chai ama uji.
Mm.
Uji tunde unataka leo. Fanya tu hivyo sababu yeye ni mgonjwa. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pedi ya tuo kimodwa. Go ni watch it, go watch it and rangi, go watch it and ya luma ka unja. Piga rangi kwa kiatu yake. Let the kiatu kama isapigwa rangi sababu huyu mtu mgonjwa. Ajui kupiga rangi vizuri. Nguo yake osha kwa sababu huyu mgonjwa, manguo za wagonjwa wanaweza naosha. Bwana sifiwe sana.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Atakula mae mtu mgonjwa atakula. Wagonjwa hawakuli mboga za yote. Mboga ni mbaya na mdomo yake. Letea mgonjwa chakula mbaya anaweza kula. Mbaya akiona hivi mgonjwa inaacha. Anapiga, anaanza kupiga stool. Bwana sifiwe sana.
Karchunja tu.
Letea mgonjwa kile imetengenezwa vizuri.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. You will have peace in that marriage. I'm telling you. You will have peace. Can lead to chimo mo chiel malo. Mamo mamo ngenye. Chuo kwa chimo mamo ngenye. Wan ringo tas kise kise tolo ringo ma pigu chue. Kore kati el ngenyani. Kiki tungu mi toye pelo matin. Kel gino kale ye meleja. Kata no paro da komore ikadem.
Okode.
Gomo dogde.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
And di chuo gno. Mami yegi paje te, nu ukumi te. We kero nuwa yu mai wako kani
mzol.
Giniri.
Come on.
Ogriti woni rito waro, churi ne waro kumiri. Nitie waro kun, nitie waro chai, nitie waro pesa. Deka nitie waro kitanda, deka nitie waro uoyo, deka nitie waro.
Come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Can you be calling me India?
Amen. Gini donjo or song saucy.
Call ritual ke kondete. Ritual maro tanda. Kano wa mkuliti. Chaki wubyo tanda. Kelo wa mkul. Mano be ziwa. Nike kide chuo. Uwoyo kako seye. A man. A man will speak after you fill his stomach. After feeling well in the stomach, then a prophet will prophesy.
Hey.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want to take the Sabbath of God now to go and rest. But remain with this our message.
Mm.
For the church of God to grow, you woman, do your part successfully. Amen.
Amen.
Ni ya sabo hilo duo. Kwa hivyo nashukuru Mungu sana.
Amen.
Kwenye haya machache ambayo tumeleta leo. Tupendane jameni, sisi ambao tuko majirani. Wakati mtumishi wa Mungu alikuwa anaanza hapa, tulikuwa na yeye.
Mm.
Na tukakuja tumeomba kwa matope hapa.
Amen.
May God bless you, man of God.
Amen.
You are sure you are seen.
Amen.
And we thank God for this.
Amen.
So I would like, we as neighbors now, I would like us to work together.
Hold hands.
Let us hold hands. So that we can visit each other. We can do some our investments. Mm. We can do some a lot of things we can do if we come together.
Amen.
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 Pastor Gambi, you know, you are friendly with many pastors around your masaria.
Mm.
Please contact those people, those pastors who are willing, so that we can hold our hands and
get a day we can meet.
Amen.
So that we can know on how we want to move.
Yes.
Working alone like this is not going to help us.
Mm.
Let us maintain love in this community.
Amen.
And so that we can work together.
Amen.
And as we used to do with Pastor Mary there.
Mm.
Yeah. You are here, Pastor Mary is there, and I'm next there. We have another pastor on the other side.
Mm.
And you know some other pastors around here. In these small churches. Let us come together so that we can do something that can expansion of this church. See what happens?
You do.
Hey, Sasa, we need to. You are a strong man, I know you.
Mm.
You are a leader. You are born to be a leader.
Amen.
You are good in connection.
Mm.
Please, I put this thing into your mind.
Amen.
Connect with these people. Let us have a day so that we can write letters to all these pastors around the Nyamasaria. The people, those are going to willing for us to work together as Nyamasaria pastors.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
So that we can move far.
Amen.
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 That's my vision.
Amen.
Let us work on it for us to see the hand of the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. God is love.
Amen.
And when we are going to maintain that love, then we are going to see the Lord.
Amen.
If we are going to work alone like this, scattered like this, we are not coming together, that is not the God will not turn in us.
It is
we are going to do our own thing.
Mm.
May God bless you so
much.
Amen. God bless you so much.
Welcome him.
Oh, allow me to welcome my brother.